Hello everybody, welcome to this video. We are here in a sequence of questions which were there in the previous year UGC NET exam. So here is a simple problem which is based on linear transformations. Look at the statement of the problem. The statement says which of the following is a linear transformation. So you are given some linear transformations and you have to find out which one is a linear transformation. So let us look at the first example. You have a transformation which takes xyz to 4 comma x plus y. So you can see that your transformation is from R3 to R2, right? They are calling it F, G and H. So T is either F or G or H, and you have to verify or you have to find out which one is a linear transformation. So let us look at the option A. You have F, X, Y, Z is given as 4 comma x plus y, and you know that for a transformation to be a linear transformation, you should have, if we take x, capital X is equal to say x1 y1 z1 and capital Y as x2 y2 z2, then you should have f of alpha x plus beta y as alpha f of x plus beta f of y. This is required for the transformation to be linear transformation. This is your requirement. Fine. Now let us look here. So you have here f of alpha x plus beta y is going to be f of alpha x1 plus beta x2 comma alpha y1 plus beta y2 comma alpha z1 plus beta z2. Fine. Now you apply f here, you will get 4 comma, you will get x plus y, that is alpha x1 plus beta x2 plus alpha y1 plus beta y2. Right. So this is your f of alpha x plus beta y. Now if you look at alpha f of x plus beta f of y, what you are going to get? You are going to get alpha, that will be 4 comma x1 plus y1 plus beta 4 comma x2 plus y2. Now you add it, you'll get 4 alpha plus 4 beta comma alpha x1 plus beta x2 plus alpha y1 plus beta y2. Now you look at these two, this one here and this one here. They are not equal, right? They are not equal because of the first component is not equal. Therefore, f of alpha x plus beta y is not equal to alpha f of x plus beta f of y. It implies f is not a linear transformation. F is not a linear transformation. Now let us look at option B. So option A is gone. Option A is not correct. Fine. Now you see similarly option B. You can just look at the option also and you can find out. Here you see the term is there xy, and you know that for linear there cannot be a product of your terms xy. So this is also not linear, but you can verify of course. And here you can verify that this is linear. Let us do that. C part, your h of xyz is z minus x comma x plus y. So I am taking again. Here, let me write down B, since there is a term xy on the right hand side, therefore non-linear. Okay, and C part, here you see you have hxyz is z minus x, x plus y. So if you take alpha x plus beta y, where x and y are same as in the A part. So this is h of alpha x1 plus beta x2 comma alpha y1 plus beta y2 comma alpha z1 plus beta z2. So this is z component, that is alpha z1 plus beta z2 minus x component minus alpha x1 minus beta x2 comma first component, that is alpha x1 plus beta x2 plus the second component plus alpha y1 plus beta y2. So I can further write it as, you can write it as alpha, you take this alpha, 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 alpha terms. So So that will be alpha z1 minus x1 comma x1 plus y1. And now you take beta, 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 beta terms. So you will have beta, you will have z2 minus x2 comma x2 plus y2. So this is h of x plus beta, this is h of y. Right. So you get h of alpha x plus beta y as alpha h of x plus beta h of y. So it implies h is a linear transformation. Now since option D is all, so that is also gone because A and B are not linear transformation. So option A is gone, B is gone, C is correct, D is gone. So C is the correct option for this problem. And this question was there in June 2015 and it was of 3 marks. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to this channel and share this video with your friends.